10 号。
It started when I was a young boy. I think I was 7-8 years old. I was passionate of pigeon sport already. I was always on the loft of my grandfather when I was on holiday, and later on the loft of my father. I have always a big passion for pigeons and football.
So it started actually from your grandfather.
He was the first one. Started actually from my grandfather, yes.
He was the first one in the Limburg dynasty.
Yeah, and when I played for first time myself on my name, it was a loft I put in the garden of my grandfather. Uh-huh. I go leave specially to the place of my grandfather to put a loft for myself to play there with the pigeons.
And your father was happy because I assume you...
Yes, my father... No. That was not played enough. I want my own loft. I will play myself, and that was in the loft of my grandfather. But the breeders were always of me and my father, you know?
Uh-huh.
I play football and I win a lot of money, and I spend a lot of money in the pigeon sport with the money I have for the football.
Everybody is curious also about Erik Limburg in football. You were a professional football player.
I started professional, but later I was a semi-professional. I go working.
Did you play for an important football team?
I started in Anderlecht. I live in Anderlecht. I was own player. I started there.
It was
I played.
One of the best teams.
That was the best team, and on that moment it was the best team. Now it's a big more problems at this moment, but at that
and
moment
striker, the best defender,
midfield.
Midfielder.
Yeah.
You were very talented.
Yeah.
Both legs?
Only one leg, but I can do everything with one. I can play inside, outside my foot, I can do everything with one.
Okay, and when did you stop totally the football and went for the pigeon sport?
I stopped when I live here, the second year I stopped with football. I
How
buy this
were
house
you back then?
30.
30? Also, you had an important career in football?
Yeah, I stopped in third national division, in third division, Standard Twitter. I played the last 4 years in Standard Twitter. Yeah. And in combination with my work in the bank office. I work in bank office and I play football.
So you took all the money from the bank and put into the pigeons?
No, that was more difficult. That must give to my wife. My money of the football was for me. Okay. I can spend who I want.
Okay. So 30 years you dedicated totally to the pigeons?
Yeah. I buy this house. The house I buy, I live before I live here, no, not anymore, but before I live here, I buy this house, and then after 1 year I stopped totally with football. It was too much. I don't know who I did it. I go work, I play football, I play pigeons, and I play very well too. When I think now, when I must do it now, I cannot believe who I did it.
How
now, all the day I'm busy with my birds.
And you said that at 7-8 years old you started with the pigeons, then together with your father you kept the breeding loft together, but you flew from different lofts. You went to your grandfather.
Yeah. My father take the first round, for example, and I take the second round.
And your father was in the same area, your grandfather?
Yes, in the same area, yeah, about 10 kilometers each other.
So everything around Brussels developed?
Yeah, around Brussels.
And back then, did you fly all the categories only for middle distance?
No, I play only short and middle distance in the beginning, yeah. The second year I was second national champion of Belgium for the beginners, you know?
Oh, you had a special championship?
You have a special champion in
for
Belgium.
How long are you considered to be a beginner? 1-2 years?
No, I think about 5 years you can
so
play.
So in the first 5 years you can... Yeah. Also, you had the
I was first provincial and second national. That was my second year I play on my own.
With what strains do you remember?
Yeah, there was a lot of Janssen bird.
A lot of Janssen.
Yeah. I have a good friend, he had a big garage and he play fantastic. And I receive all the birds of him. I have very good birds. My father start to play well when I have the birds, you know. And we take some birds of good fancers of long distance too. For example, I remember a Norman bird I introduced. a very good we bought with my father. When we bought a bird, it was a good one to introduce with the short distance bird.
We would like you to give us some advice for the young fanciers, yeah. And not only, there are a lot of old fanciers,
yeah,
of that
course.
Keep trying to do good results, but they don't have the recipe of success. Maybe your advice
is good. Advice, you must start with good birds. But you can do it on a cheap way, for example. You go to very good players and you ask to buy some eggs on the end of the season. I think you can do it on a cheap way, but you have quality birds. And what's very important is that you make a very good selection. That's for me very important. Then you have the good birds, but all the good birds breed not all good birds. And that the most of people forget that. And that's one of the most important things in the selection.
And how do you do this?
I can tell you I sell 4 or 5 times all my birds, and I start again. What I do when I stop, I think now I breed of all my best birds 3-4 nests, and then I started to breed with them. But after 3-4 years, for example, now of each very good bird, I have perhaps 2-3 of the 8 I breed, you know, they are not all good. And that's important to make
How do you think which one are very good? Or
You can handle them. That's the first thing you do, but because you have no results. In the beginning, on my breeding loft, were birds with no results. My best ones, every time I sold them. But I have the brothers and sisters and I handle them and I think that are good ones. And then I breed of them and I see after 2 years, you see what bird give good family, you see, good children.
But I think for this you are very famous because you are the one that made total sales a few times. And
people say I have good feeling to make couples, to pairing. But that when I was young, I paired already the birds on my father's place always, I paired. I make the pairs, always. When I was 12 years old,
long wing with a short wing.
Yeah, I complete. I try to complete when I think that's not so good on that bird, I try to complete with the other side of the hen or the cock.
Okay, so this comes with the flair that you have.
Yeah.
It's a special talent, a special gift that you have.
Perhaps it's a feeling, it's what I think, yeah.
Okay.
But you must always start with good birds, eh? Don't forget it. Eh? You can make the bird all you want, but I have in my memory a bird, a prototype, like you have a car, mm-hmm. I have a prototype in my mind, and that I breed. After 2 times breeding, I can make of a bird I introduce, who is not so good, I can make a bird on the type I want, because I cross them and I breed them and I make them my profile.
Okay, but if we take one beginner, for example, for him it's a bit impossible to have your talent, only if he gains your talent, but this is one in 1,000.
What I can tell to a beginner is to look, to try to see good birds, to handle many, many good birds.
So to
then you have an idea, that bird is a good one. To handle the best bird. When I was young, every week there was sailing. I live near Brussels and there was a sailing of all the good fanciers who sail birds. And you can look to the birds. You have 1 hour on Saturday, the birds are sold Sunday. You have 1 hour to see the birds on Saturday evening. Every Saturday evening I go with my father, look to the birds. All the birds, I handle birds. Then you can make
an idea of
feeling,
how it should like.
But you have different types of good birds.
That's why. Do you think a good bird here is a good bird also?
You have different types.
Because
one thing I can say, a good bird has always good feathers. I never saw a good bird without good feathers. The
what
quality of the feather
what means good
is all very soft,
silky,
very soft. Also, the condition is important for the feathers.
That's why if he has a good
bird. When a bird is not in condition, that Norbert can feel it immediately. The birds feel not silky. He feel dry, eh? Norbert, I think.
Sure.
Yeah.
He told me also to breed a beautiful bird. It's easy. That's right. Good work is difficult.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, but the thing is that his birds are also beautiful and good.
Yeah.
Why are you breed beautiful birds? It's interesting when people come for buy birds, they like a beautiful.
He can also is a very very good player. He can very good prepare his birds. That's one of his the most quality of him, I think. He can prepare.
Also, yeah, that's
Yeah, but also he's been looking for this all his life. Yeah. Mm. He came to you. He went to different exhibitions. He spoke a lot with. So you try to gain information and to put it.
You must always try to go to the best ones. To the best ones in everything.
Hybrid pigeons.
But you need to go always to the best ones. To the condition is also one of the most important factors of in the pigeon sport. Okay. At first, you need good ones.
Good ones. So
when I have no good ones, you have no chance. You have no chance.
What's the next important aspect?
Condition, huh?
Okay. And for this?
You need a vet, huh? But you have many, but you need a very good one. Huh? Okay, naturally, for a beginner, he must go regularly. But you must know I'm more than 50 years in the pigeon sport, I see a lot. Because my racing birds I do myself, I clean myself every day. I do all myself on the racing birds when during the season I do all myself. Why? Because I will see a lot. Now already you see what happened on the loft. They're already on the loft where I go play them next year. And I see already that bird won't that, that bird don't like his neighbor or he don't like that bird. You must remember it.
The and best birds have something in common on how they organize inside the loft?
The best birds you can motivate. Bad birds territory. You cannot, territorium or neighbor or other basket or different things, but that you must see as the fencer.
Yeah.
But therefore you need to be with your birds. You must not drink coffee in the kitchen, take the birds. No, no. That.
How many sometimes hours a day do you spend inside the loft?
No, not so lot. Now 2 hours a day. But in season it's more. Eh?
Like how? How much?
Well, it can be 6-7 hours a day. And I have someone who helps me to clean the breeders and so on. I do
so
just
racing?
On the racing period I do just racing birds, youngsters, hens and cocks. It's more than enough.
Okay.
And I'm not a big massa. I like to have the feeling,
of
what's on the loft. Eh? I can 120, 100 birds I can do. I never do more. Less yes, but not more. That's why I don't change my loft.
We will go.
But now,
the
yeah, but you can see they are not full, filled up.
You don't fill them up. You leave
I have space. But and every year I change. Eh? I put my yearlings, the youngsters, I put on a separated loft. That most of people say you must let the bird on the basket where you give him, and you let them there. But I do never do that. Every year I change.
Why do you do this?
It's a motivation. But now it's a motivation.
Fight again to gain their position.
You know that bird now is bird and now is basket of the year before. He still remember that. Eh? Sometimes you can use it to play with him. For example, my 555. He take 3 lofts. He had a basket in 3 lofts. Different basket, eh? But they know it. Eh? He go to top of and he take the basket there, in the middle, for example, one on the floor and one upstairs. 3 different lofts.
And he won on these 3 different, or?
I just do it before a big race. Eh? You cannot motivate a bird every race. Eh? Then you have no effect anymore. Eh? That's important to have the effect on the race you want to have. Eh? You cannot do it every time. Eh?
You knew it.
You can do 1, 2, 3, it's difficult.
You need from the beginning of the season what 3.5 is going to achieve.
I try before. Eh? You must not do it just before basketing. Eh? Then the bird don't know what will happen. Eh? I try it already before. I look already. Perhaps it will that or that. That's to be fancier, you know.
Coming back to the beginners, you said good feathers, good condition of the bird. Mm. What else is important when you handle one bird?
The equilibration, for example. I handle very quick. When I go to auction, I handle very quick, I take bird. And when I feel the equilibration is not good, I put him again. He must fall in my hand. Mm-hmm. That's one of my prototypes I have in my head. I take, I feel it, and then I don't look anymore. Put them again.
And regarding the strength, does it matter if it's big back or not?
Well,
really?
I like big back, but I like equilibration is more important than one piece, eh? Not a bird in two pieces. Like
I
you
remember
said,
when you told me this.
One piece, I like one block of granite. That's what I. But yeah, it's difficult to explain it, you know. Therefore, you must handle birds, and that's why it's important to have good birds in your hand. Mm-hmm. That you must learn for yourself.
Okay, so this comes with the talent, and then a simple advice. So go buy from the best.
Yeah, but you can do it on cheap wheel.
Because you said out of 100, only 5 are very good.
Yeah.
The other
that's what I say, eh? The selection is very important. Eh?
And how shall we do this?
They are all very good pedigree, but that's not enough. Eh? The paper can be very beautiful, but you must look first the bird. Eh?
Okay, and how
that's
do you
that's my
this?
Mind.
How do you do this selection? This selection in flight or?
First in feeling. I tell you, on my breeding loft, now I have a lot of good birds on my breeding loft, but sometimes I have no good birds on my breeding loft because they are sold. Now I don't sold not all my good birds anymore, but before I sold my good birds.
But the selection you mean in hand, and after that
and then
you do something special to select?
In hand, family, pedigree is important. Eh? Don't forget, pedigree is important, family. I like good family. A family who give many times good birds, I like. I like a family, for example, who give birds who can fly with a big difference before the others. I like very much because it's something in the genes, I think. And then I breed of them, and the ones I think they are good in hand, I handle them, I paired up. And then I make the selection with the youngsters. The youngsters, they are racing for the selection. And when I see they never give good youngsters, they go out. Eh? But most of time, my selection is good.
And this selection in flight of the youngsters, mm-hmm.
I start already as youngster.
Do they have to do something special to be kept in the loft? To
as
win
young,
one race, two races?
No, as youngster not.
You don't?
They go on the race and I look the way they came back. I have some with good results, but sometimes I take one who had not raced very well as youngsters. And after he's very good. As youngster, I look the condition who they came back. They are fresh. They are good, but the result is not so important as youngster for me.
And as
later as yearling, yes. But the first year I can take, for example, my Gilbert.
Yeah.
It was nothing special as youngster, really. I think it was hen. When he raised as youngster, he put him always in the basket as hen when he was youngster. After us hearing, it was the best bird ever flight.
And the youngsters, how far do you go with them? How many times, how far?
When the condition of my youngsters is good, they do the 4 national races or 5 national races.
This means 4 times 500?
4 or... But it depends on the condition of my birds. Eh? That it's important eh? Before you basketing. But normally they race for the 4 races for the youngsters. 4 times 500 kilometers.
And then as yearling, what do they have to do to go?
As yearling, they must fly on the top 1 or 2 times. Eh?
Top means first 100, first 50, first...
I like a bird to fly first in 100.
In the first one?
One time, so I like very much. But I hold also, but I don't hold the birds to fly every time in the with prices on 21%. No, he must fly on one
first 1%.
First 1%. Yeah.
And the others all the out.
Out. But I raced many times. Already they go out. They cannot follow my system because I raised a system of German. I start with 100 and I go to 800.
Every week?
Sometimes every week 700 kilometers, and then you make a hard selection. But that's hard for earrings, it's hard. Certainly for cocks. And can do it more easier than a cock. That's my feeling. But I can do it with a cock also. But I do it one or two times only. But my hands race every week.
No matter the distance?
No. I think a hand must race every week. But sometimes I take them back. Eh? I play a race of 600 and the week after I play 300. That's training.
Mm-hmm. And you've been doing this system since you were little, or you adapted it? Once was like this, once was...
I do it already a long time, because in the beginning nobody did it. I remember when I was young, older people tell you are a killer, you kill the pigeons. Now everybody do it. He play every week, everybody do it. But I see you must race with the bird. Before, when my father was with me, he tell me, you kill your birds. And one time I play bushes. He tell you who play your bird the week before. Of course, I say, you're crazy. Okay, I listen to you, I tell. For example, 30 youngsters, my 15 best ones I take at home. And my bad ones...
went to the race.
I play. I go to the race the week before. Now, on bush, my birds arrive. My 14 first birds, or 14 birds who race the week before. But the best ones don't race before. Eh? Mm-hmm. All say to my father, you see what happened now. After he never say something, but it's really so. Huh?
When was this? What year?
Oh, that's long time ago. in the 80, beginning of 80, perhaps 83, 84. But that's what I remember. It's an anecdote that I remember very good.
And you
before
said
people say the old. Players before Van den Brialen, Vreeken, they play every three weeks. Eh? What I do also is I introduce short birds on long distance birds. I cross them. They tell to me, the old fans before, the big fans tell to me, cannot be good. You will have not a long distance race and you have not a short distance race anymore. I started with the short distance birds of my father, for example. I started and I race with them. In the beginning, I race one, two times, and third time, he come not back and
could not break.
But I have some birds who can do it three times. And with these birds, you must continue. That bird you must take for you. Mm. And that bird have also speed and it's honest. That's so, why I say selection for me is very important thing.
So going back to your beginnings, you said that as a beginner you won on your second year a very important national trophy.
Yeah.
And I'm curious.
But I play very well already. Yeah? Since I start myself, I play just with young birds, but because I have not so many time with you.
I was only 18. Eh? I start on 18 on myself. Eh? I can just drive with car. And then
how did you train them back then? With bicycle or?
No. I can just drive with car. Ah. I was just 18.
So you took the driving license?
On my holiday, I remember the second year with my youngster, I was one of the best. But I drive every day. And I go play different places. Eh? I go to the big races. It can be other side, but when I race to the other side, I go train my birds. All the week on that side with my car. I think they come there all the week because they say the wind is not good and you play there, but It's okay.
And they adapt. When you take them here and next day here,
you
no
adapt.
Problem.
But then I drive a lot.
Tell us, what was your first important prize that you made? And if you remember that race, first national, first international, the first race when you...
83.
In 1983.
Yeah, I play also, but on other place in Anderlecht I play with other person, with Lemaire. I play the same day, two times first national. First time I play longer distance race, I play La Souterraine on the end of the year.
How many kilometers were?
565.
And how many did you just basketed?
Myself?
No, the race.
I think met the young Sturz 9000 and met the old birds 3000. And I played two times first national on the same race. But my youngster was 5 minutes earlier than my old one. Yeah. It was not so good flight, it was a little rainy flight.
Yeah. What strain was that bird? Also the Janssen?
Also the Janssen crossed with birds I introduced. Yeah. I remember the old bird Verstrater bought it after. Because I make auction and Verstrater bought that bird.
The yearling.
Yeah. And the youngsters, my partner, receive it because he take the youngsters. When I go separate, he take the youngster and he take that bird. But I have, on that family, I have a lot also. But it was my old strain of Janssen crossed with long distance bird.
So this was the first success of your, big success of your experience?
I remember the youngster was a youngster of the third round. It was very young. And the week before I told my partner, I think it will fly the first. We put it on short distance, 170 kilometers. But it flew not priced. It arrived 2 hours later. So it's not possible. I tell him, I go basket them again. In that week, in the week after its flight, first, the quickest of all the birds.
And it was bad weather that day?
Yeah, it was not good, it was a little rainy weather.
It
was a quick.
It's going to make it?
It was a quick flight, eh? Yeah. Yeah, I feel it was a good bird, it was motivated for the nest, but I put 5 eggs under the bird. Every day I put 1 egg more. You see, I was 20 years old, I look in the books, I read a lot. I try everything, you know. But I motivate my birds. Huh?
And when did all your project meet Dr. Peters? And why? I know that your client...
Always I hear Dr. Peters was the best. The best fancers in the area go to Dr. Peters. Yeah, automatically you go to Dr. Peters. My first veterinary was Dr. Lemayeux, and after I went to Dr. Norbert.
But even so, he's very good, but I can see you don't have too many products of his exposed here.
Yes, but I've not everything I exposed. Eh?
No, good
products you cannot always expose, eh, Nars? You see, I have products. Yeah, I use different products. I have also products of Norbert in my.
So you
see, here I have also products. I have also good products inside that I.
Let's do this.
You know, the people come always when they come drink coffee. I put my tasks, they put always the tasks coffee here. And then they look quickly, you see?
But I so show.
I don't show everything.
What do you think?
Here in my. I have also. You see? Steel products from Norbert, vitamins, aminozuren, steel products of Norbert. A vaccine of Norbert, again paratyphus.
And what do you think it's Norbert's best product, in your opinion, or it's a combination of?
What's the best product? The product where the bird, you see when you give it to the bird.
React immediately.
Immediate reaction. When I give a product of Norbert, it depends what they have. And I see the reaction the day after, I know that's what I need, you know? But what's the best product of Norbert? Medicines of Norbert are good, but what medicine? When my birds are not sick, I don't need it.
But so during the season, don't you try to prevent something?
No. Normally, I do it on my feeling. Mm-hmm. I give protection on my feeling. When I don't know, really, I don't know it, I go to Norbert.
It's more important, the fancier than the bird, I think. It's very important, the fancier.
It's Bengal. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's why I will win, you know. My neighbor is very good on short distance. When 1 week, the first week he had one or two birds before me, I don't like that. Eh? I cannot. But normally in the beginning I don't show my hands, you know. But I have a friend, Patrick, he said, not show, eh? Wait, eh? Wait. Eh? But when he is not here, quickly I put two, three hands in the gang before the loss. DC already dance to motivate them a little. You know, I cannot play without motivation to win. When I play, I will win.
So you told us about your first important result. But mm-hmm. What is your most beautiful result made so far? The most important race with your dearest bird.
One of the most important results I've got last year, eh? But it was not so fantastic anymore after. Eh? You know,
totally,
but that bird for me is the most important bird I ever got. I've got very good birds. I've Gilbert, I've Lucky 85, Lucky 77, but that bird is never sold him.
Triple five,
yeah.
So triple five in 2017 won fifth Barcelona.
Yeah. 30 National Valence.
What distance? Can you also say the distance, because the people
670 kilometer Valence. That was the race before Barcelona, and then after he fly 5 National Barcelona. After I put him again on Perpignan, he arrived quickly in the morning, but totally injured. Eh? His back was open, he had no feather in the back, I have pictures of it. Eh? It was totally blessed. Eh? I don't know who he can arrive at home. I never forget that. I see arrive a bird. I say he had not Uzegza start in things. He had not tail anymore. Eh? I say what happened. It was triple five. But he fly 200 national. Eh? He still fly 200 national, eh? Because I use that prize for the Olympic Olympiade. Eh? He's with that prize Olympiade, and I can. With that bird happened a lot of things. He fly normally 30 National Valence. I can use it for Olympiade, he won't use it.
Don't tell what
no.
They did bad or did.
But no. But after the year after, he fly 5 National Barcelona again. But you must know, all the flights he fly, it was very hard weather. Eh? 35 degrees, headwind, the birds arrived next day. 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock from Barcelona. The first year 3 o'clock, the second year 12 o'clock, 2 times 5 national. On Perpignan 10 o'clock, again 5 national normally.
So you named it triple five because 2017 he had 5th on Barcelona.
Mm-hmm.
Next year again
5th Barcelona.
Fifth Barcelona. And the same year the last race, 5th at Perpignan. So that's when you put
it was the best long distance bird to fly. Eh?
And you will never sell it.
No.
That's the icon.
I believe in that bird. It's a bird I can good motivated also. I think he will give it.
Good
this chance. Year my second best young bird was already a son of him. Young bird, eh? I tell. I have only one old bird I raise. All the yearling I raised, it was a lead bird of the year before, but I put him already on Narbonne, 870 kilometers, and he fly in the first 10%. And the race before he fly Aurillac, also in the first 10%. I believe also in that bird, I think it will be a very good breeder.
Can we see him to triple five?
Yeah, of course.